Little Skeletons, it's Disney Queen Skelly here, and welcome back to another Chatting Skeletons episode. So this episode is called Our Scary Indiana Jones Adventure. So I'm going to take you a little further back. I don't know if you guys remember the Pride video that I did a review, a reacting to video for. Go back and watch it if you haven't. It should have the date on there for when she uploaded it, which was, I believe, the day we went. If not, it should be one of my Disneyland trips that I put the date on. But anyways, Harley Baby has always been afraid of two particular rides at Disneyland, which was Indiana Jones and Haunted Mansion. Though I completely forgot about the Haunted Mansion one, and I just kind of kept taking her on it. And then after a while, I felt really, really bad about it. But then I was like, eh, she's getting used to it. She's not complaining, and she's not saying no. If it was any a bother, I'm sure she'd tell me. But anyway, so we were walking past Indiana Jones, and she's like, you know what? I want to try it. I was like, are you sure? She goes, yes, I have you with me. I want to try it. I was like, okay. So she tried it, and she came out perfectly fine. So every so often, whenever we go to Disney, we try Indy, but I always let her tell me if she wants to try it, because if she doesn't, I'm not going to force her to do it. So this particular trip, we went on Indiana Jones, and we were sitting in the third row. Now, I'm going to add that Harley Baby has acrylics on, at least at the time she did. She had fake nails on, and I have pretty slender fingers with kind of long-ish nails, but not too long. So we were in the third row, and this was getting towards the very end of the ride. And it's where Indy is, like, on the boulder, and you're ready to drop. Well, after that, I felt a hand grip my shoulder. And I thought it was Harley Baby. So I just kind of let her grip there. I didn't reach for her hand, I just let her grip. And then we come out, and, you know, it's kind of daylight, and I see both her hands are gripped. Well, not daylight, but it's, like, lit by the lights in the interior. So I gripped her, I see that her hands are still gripped on the bar. I was like, hey, were you okay? She goes, yeah, why? I'm like, well, you gripped my shoulder. She goes, no, I didn't. She goes, I thought you gripped my shoulder, or I thought my necklace had fallen. I was like, no, I didn't do that to you. So ever since then, it always freaked us out to get the third row on Indiana Jones. And thankfully, ever since then, I think we only had gotten the third row once, and that incident hadn't happened again. But it was so freaky. Like, oh my god. You don't expect shit like that to happen. Like, you hear stories about things happening to other people at Disneyland, but you don't particularly think you're ever going to experience something like that. So the fact that we actually did experience that just makes it all the more creepy. We hopefully will never have to experience that again, but even if it does happen, I mean, I did a bunch of research, and I couldn't find anything on Indiana Jones being haunted or having any incidences on the ride, so I mean, I don't know. Maybe it was just a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Let me know if you guys have ever had any creepy experiences at Disneyland yourself, or maybe on the Indiana Jones attraction, too. Maybe we're not alone in this. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, little skeletons. Stay safe. I love you guys.